In our environment, we have two virtual machines supporting the web tier of our on-premises application, and they are under excessive load. In many cases, you can easily set up the ability for workloads to burst into further capacity on-premises, but what happens if you have no more capacity available? Azure, with its bottomless capacity, can become an instant extension of your data center. Let me show you how. Starting with Operations Manager, I mentioned that the web tier was under load, and I have OM ready to respond to any alerts. Now let's refresh our environment to see the latest information. You can see here that we've just received a CPU performance alert. Let's delve a little bit deeper. You can see how this alert corresponds to one of our VMs in the web tier. And we have a rule that states that if our tier hits 100% for a specific time period, then throw an alert. However, not as all it seems. This alert has triggered a service manager incident as well. Let's move to SM to continue the flow. Now, Service Manager enables us to create long-running workflows across multiple systems. In this case, we're using Service Manager to respond to certain alerts in OM, and in our case, the capacity alert. And within a few seconds, a new incident has been created via the OM alert. And we've set up this incident to open a change request via a service request. And we can see this happening in the workflows. Now I'm going to view all open service requests, and we can see our SR is being created. Now I want to view the activities of the service request. Now this is the information I want the SR to actually follow. And you can see we have an activity in progress. Now my first step was information gathering, which is compiling the information in relation to the original request. Now this is mainly from Ops Manager, but can be from multiple places within your system center environment. In the second step, the SR activity is actually executing a runbook. Now, a runbook activity defines further information which may be needed to continue the workflow, such as an approval process. For our example, we have a single runbook which we can easily view its current state. To view a runbook in progress, the link opened up the Orchestrator console. Here I can see all the current runbooks, their state and history. And in the OR console, let's see the runbook instances for this web tier scale, and you can see our runbook is in current execution. Now, the runbook itself has a decision point to either burst on-premise or into Azure, and this is based on capacity available. The path taken is provisioning a new virtual machine in Azure via PowerShell. Now, if we move to Azure and then refresh our instances, we can see a new VM is being provisioned. This can be provisioned from our custom library or copy directory from our on-premises store as well. For instant speed, we could have VMs offline in Azure, and then the workflow can simply start them up and deploy the latest application update as needed. With the integration of System Center Virtual Machine Manager, Ops Manager, and Service Manager, including Orchestrator, you can easily automate responses to capacity situations, and with the seamless integration into Azure, can take advantage of the unlimited capacity it can provide as a simple extension of your data center.